Hi friends, in this video we see APAM related questions asked in NTRB 2016. So here they have given APAM diagram and they ask what is the output voltage. So what we have to find is we have to find output voltage VO, right? That is the question. How to find? Right, first we assume that we know that the op-amp input current is zero, so the voltage at these two points are same. Let me assume the voltage at this point is VP, the voltage at this point is VQ. So this, and we also know that both the terminals are having the same potential, VP is equal to VQ. So first we find VP, from that we find a VO, right? How? Let us see. Apply KCL, right? For this one. So what is the voltage here? VP, here also VP, right? So I apply KCL, 2 minus VP by R plus 1 minus VP by R, right? Incoming current is equal to outgoing is that is equal to VP by R, right? Incoming is equal to outgoing, fine. Okay, so let us see what we have to do here. It is coming, right? It's coming here, it's coming here, this is going. So if we simplify, RRR cancels, so 2 minus VP plus 1 minus VP is equal to VP. This implies VP is equal to 1 volt, right? So VP is equal to 1 volt. We know VP is equal to VQ. So VQ is also 1 volt. Fine. Okay. So both the terminals are having a voltage 1 volt, right? Okay. Sorry. So here also 1 volt, here to 1 volt. Fine. Now what I have to find? I have to find VO, right? Please bear with me. So VO, how to find VO? In order to find VO, I do one thing. I apply KCL again here, right? So the input voltage is 0 volt here. So 0 minus 1 divided by R is equal to 1 minus VO divided by 2R, right? RR cancel. This implies 1 minus VO by 2 is equal to minus 1. This implies VO is equal to 3 volt, right? So option D is a right answer, right? Simple one, right? Next we see some other question. Okay, this question they have asked in NTRB 2016. What is the question? In the figure, VI is specified as 1 millivolt. So input voltage is 1 millivolt. What is the value of output voltage? They ask what is the output voltage and they are given the diagram, right? So input is DC. It's not AC. So when you give, see here it is 0 volt only, it has no issues. It is 1 volt. Right, here it is 1 volt DC, means here also we have 1 volt, right? Because both the terminals are at the same potential. So this is 1 volt. DC means for DC capacitor is open, so we can cut. So C can be removed. Why C is removed? Because input is DC, 1 volt, right? So now you see the diagram. Sorry, I removed a resistor, you remove this capacitor, right? Okay, right, remove this. So C can be removed. Now the circuit becomes a non-inverting amplifier like this, right? So it is 10 ohm, right? So it is becoming like this, minus plus, right? It is going like this. It is 1k ohm, right? Now VO Clear, it is 1 volt. Right, this is 0 volt, right, because it is 0. Here it is 1 volt. It is like a non-inverting amplifier. We know for non-inverting amplifier, it is VI, right? So it's VI, so not 1 volt, sorry. It is VI. For non-inverting amplifier, gain is VO by VI is equal to 1 plus RF divided by R1. Fine. Sorry. Please. Right? So, 1 plus RF by R1. RF is 1K. R1 is 10K. So, sorry, 10 ohm. VO by VI is equal to 1 plus RF is 1K. 1000 ohm. R1 is 10 ohm. That is 100. So 101. So VO by VI gain is 101. What is the VI given? VI is 1 millivolt. So VO is equal to VI into 101. 101 into VI is 1 millivolt. That is equal to 101 millivolt. So what is the option? Our option B is a correct answer, right? So I hope you understand both the problems very clearly. If you are having any doubt, please ask me in comment section. I will clarify all your doubts. Thank you.